just gonna stretch my legs a bit and do all that, go to the washroom, and I will be right back. Shouldn't be too long. Right now we got 7 donors, we're at 330, goal is 500, going good. So I'll see you in a couple of minutes. Alright, we are back. We'll keep going with the Horizon Zero Dawn. Here we go. Here we go. Or skill points, that's not too bad. I forgot I had concentration. Give me a minute here. Alright, what did I want to do? Do I have any quests? I guess we can do a small little side mission.
This should be quite
good. No! Oh no. Damn it. Oh no. Oh no.
A quick way down.
No. Guess that's not where I'm supposed to go. Oh, okay.
How am I gonna get down from here? Ah, this should be quite the ride.
Okay. It just let me fall to my death? What the fuck? Did I miss something? Just give me a minute here, I just have to do a quick phone call, get my supper. All right, let's try this again.
Now, how am I going to get down from here? Oh, this should be quite the ride.
What the I don't get that part. Alright.
Now, how am I gonna get down from here? Ah, this should be quite the ride.
I have no clue where I need. This should be the easiest thing ever, and yet cannot do it. Let's try my other way. And
now, how am I gonna get down from here? Huh. This should be quite the ride.
Oh great, I fell in a hole.
getting down fast.
Great, we made it. Just run away. Just run away. The fuck do I...
Go!
get out of this.
I'm glad that's over with. Thanks for the help.
What are you doing out here all alone? Where are your men?
I'm not gonna risk their lives. I don't mind putting my worthless ass on the line, but not theirs. Sorry I had to drag you into it.
Don't worry. This is just an average day for me. You know, take down some machines, track some killers.
Right. I'd hate to see a busy morning for you. Ready to get started?
Are you sure you're all right?
Well, I'm sober, so... no.
All right.
Well, I'm glad you're thinking straight, at least.
Don't get used to it.
Tell me exactly what happened to Ursa. Start from the beginning.
No one knows for sure. She left in the middle of the night with a few of her best men.
Her best men? But she didn't bring you?
No. I'd been drinking a lot. Or maybe she thought... damn, I don't know. I couldn't hack it. Search parties found their bodies the next day, and the corpses of some Shadow Carja cowards. It was an ambush.
God damn.
Shadow Carja are animals. They beat her so bad we can't even show her face before burial.
I'm so sorry, Erend.
Yeah, well, when I find the soldiers who did this... they'll be sorry, too.
All right. Show me where Ursa fell, and I'll do what I can to help.
Come on, follow me.
I follow.
Why would Ursa come all the way out here?
I don't know. It doesn't make sense.
Is this Shadow Carja territory?
No. They broke the ceasefire as soon as they set foot in the cliff.
Fuck, thank God I didn't decide to just keep walking.
This is it, where the ambush happened. Our soldiers have been over it, but maybe that fancy artifact of yours can find a clue or something. Please. I need to find the bastards that did this.
There must be Shadow Carja armor. These look like drag marks. Arrows scattered there. Those bloodstains, not the kind that would pool around a corpse. A Shadow Carja spear. They look like snares. Strange. Not a scratch on it. It's perfectly sharp. Never seen action. Did someone move a body through here?
What do you see there?
This stain forms a line, as if blood dripped off the edge of something, like a cart. See? Cart tracks. I think someone moved the bodies here. Then scattered them across the field.
Wait. Are you saying the dead found here were killed somewhere else? But why would the Shadow Carja do that?
At this point, I'm not taking it for granted that the Shadow Carja are responsible.
Of course they were.
Well, let's follow these tracks and find out.
Gobble, gobble, gobble. Gobble, gobble, gobble. Duck must have a hard time with the cart.
Figure it out.
That quick second here.
These guys aren't Shadow Carja. They're from my tribe, the Oseram.
Is this how your people usually greet each other?
To me, you jump!
Fall back and circle around!
Gosh darn it.
To me, you chucks!
Let's see how they...
What the fuck?
I think it's calling in machines. Get ready.
Watch for an opening, then take a step!
Thank you. shit. Fuck me. Come on.
Uh-oh. What's that?
I think it's calling in machines. Get ready. Jesus Christ.
Asaram, not Shadow Carja. Looks like I was wrong about everything, as usual. Please, use that second sight of yours. I have to know what really happened.
I'm on it. Those rocks, they're shattered. What are those leather straps? Looks like you could mount some equipment on that thing. These look like Vanguard weapons. Something hit these stones. Something I've never seen before. There's no blood on them. Ursa's men didn't fight back. Armor straps. Cut with a knife. And a rock with blood on it. There, by the tripod. They used power cell.
Talk to Aerith.
This is Ursa's helmet. I thought she died in the field below, but must have been here. All this trickery. For what? Feels like it's just a torture me.
I have a theory. But it takes a little imagination.
So far, your theories are better than other people's facts.
All right. I think the Oseram ambushed Ursa and her men with a new weapon. They mounted it on that tripod up there. It fires maybe sound. Looks like it cracked the stone that
I will be right back.
I think it paralyzes people instead of killing them. It dropped the vanguard right there. No blood on their weapons. No fight.
Why paralyze them if you're only gonna move them and gut them?
They were trying to hide something. Look here, a bloody rock.
That they used to smash Ursa's face in.
Or someone else's. These leather straps have been cut, as if they took the armor off someone.
That can't be. Her body is lying in state in Meridian. I saw it.
You said she was unrecognizable. Maybe they switched another body into her armor, someone around the same size, and mutilated it enough. So it could have been anyone, even Ursa. Go back to Meridian. Take another look at that body. If it's really Ursa, of course I'm wrong. But if I'm right,
then my sister could be alive. I'm going. Meet me back there when you can.
Ready? All right, I'll take a small lunch break. I'll be back around 5:30. So I will be back pretty soon. Just gonna go eat a bit. All right, we're back before 5:30. I ate a bit faster, watched one YouTube video, and then I was like, okay, let's get back. Let's not waste too many time here. Too much time here. Want it to be as complete as possible for the 25 hours. So back to the game, we're good, everything seems to be operational. 1212, groovy. Oh. Mike, can we fast travel over there? If this one's used, I'm
looking at you.
All right.
Some Oseron girl applied to the city guard. Amazing. Redmaw, a thunderjaw with scars from countless battles. Man.
Vanguard has earned our position.
There are no shadows under the moon.
Greetings, Aloy. I am known as Blameless Marad. Please come with me. You're needed for an important consultation.
Yes, yes,
indeed. What
do
you mean? Where's Erend?
He's inside, attending the Sun King, where we should be without further delay. Follow me, please.
All of these people are here to see the Sun King.
Yes, and each has come to ask a favor of him. Unpleasant, but that's politics. The Sun King is eager to meet you, the machine tamer with a curious eye for detail. It's all very intriguing.
I'm not here to intrigue you.
Too late.
Gonna walk a bit faster than this.
Oseron gets special treatment, and now outlanders from the savage east? What possible interest could the Sun King have?
Passed by some outlander woman? I panic 2 hours, and Miss Nora goes to the front of the line.
Ignore them. Nobles are like children who whine when they don't get a second helping of dessert.
What's the Sun King like?
The most important thing is what he isn't like. His father. I think you'll find him to be a reasonable man.
Aloy of the Nora. She who sees the unseen. Welcome. It would seem you have done me a great service. Erend, tell her what you found.
I checked Ursa's tomb. You were right, Aloy. The body is missing below her right knee. I gave it to Ursa when we were kids, fighting over a toy sword.
If the body is not Ursa's, then we must assume she is still alive. And I will not abandon her.
We only know she was taken, not who took her.
I can help with that. Ursa has an enemy among the Oseron. A warlord named Dervon.
Impossible. Every clan in the claim has been hunting for him since the liberation. He has to be dead by now.
No other Oseron had the motive and ingenuity to lure Ursa into this trap. I expect to find him lurking somewhere near the border. I've already sent an agent to investigate. He'll be waiting for word from us at the marketplace in Pitchcliff.
I can't move troops to the border without provoking the Oseron. But I could send a few vanguardsmen. And perhaps an exceptionally gifted Nora as well?
I guess so.
Erend, Marad, let me discuss it with her privately. I hate to impose further after all you've done, but this is a matter of great importance to me.
It sounds like Ursa means a lot to you.
Without her Oseron vanguard, I would not have been able to liberate Meridian and end my father's brutal reign. Since then, it has been difficult to maintain peace between our tribes. But Ursa has a way of making her people see reason. So you see, I need her back at my side. And quickly.
Who is Dervahl exactly?
To understand Dervahl, you must first understand my father. He truly thought of himself as a sun god. His mind was broken. He believed that blood sacrifice would solve, well, everything. So he raided the other tribes for victims, especially the Oseron. Dervahl fought back. He crafted powerful weapons and rallied his people. My father responded with the ultimate cruelty. He captured Dervahl's wife and daughter and sacrificed them in the Sun Ring.
Hmm.
So, why would Dervahl go to so much trouble to kidnap Ersa?
He felt she betrayed him. She fought by his side until she realized he planned to raise Meridian and butcher its people. And she came to me. Together, we stopped him and liberated the city from my father. Dervahl has spent every moment since trying to get revenge. Mostly on the other Oseram who fought with us. He made so many powerful enemies. I thought we'd seen the last of him. I was wrong.
You were wrong indeed.
The killers. They attacked the Nora. I've discovered that they're a faction of Shadow Carja called the Eclipse. They're digging up ancient weapons. Machines that corrupt and control other machines. They want to use them to strike Meridian.
What you're saying echoes reports I've received from Murad. A Shadow Carja splinter group. Corrupted machines across the land. When will this attack come, do you know?
I'm not exactly sure.
And we will do what we can to prepare. But in the meantime, Ersa is my highest priority. Please, help me find her.
I'd like to ask you something about the Sundom and its politics.
By all means.
They call you a sun god who killed his own father in order to unite the tribes in harmony. Is any of it true?
They say you can see the invisible, split an arrow at 50 paces, and tame machines at a glance. How much of that is true?
It's not too far off.
Well, I would like to unite the tribes in harmony, but you saw how many courtiers I have to deal with first. Maybe next week.
Quite a place you've got here. You can almost see the little people below the mesa.
You don't approve? Well, I have a secret for you. Neither do I. But we must be patient. Change won't come in a single sunrise.
Oh, shit.
Will it happen at all, while men live in palaces?
It might. Eventually. If people like you help me bring it about.
Your politics seem very complicated. The Oseram are friends, but enemies too?
I couldn't have liberated Meridian without the help of Ersa and her Oseram freebooters. Many of them have settled here. But the Ealdermen of the Oseram clans and the Claim have become jealous of their success. So have many Carja nobles. It's a volatile situation, especially given the fact that my father raided the Oseram for years. Ersa helps keep the peace, promising a future based on mutual gain. But some, like Dervahl, will never let go of their venom.
Just a minute, I'm just writing a quick tweet there.
What can you tell me about the Shadow Carja? What do they have to do with Ersa?
They are remnants of my father's regime, holding out at the fortress of Sunfall to the west. Like him, they care only for domination, and seek to draw upon the power of the sun by spilling blood in its name. Since Ersa helped me take this city from them, they were perfect scapegoats. Dervahl knew this, of course, and planned it well.
I need to get going.
I know. Well, they say kings should never beg. But please, help me find Ursa.
Who says that?
Well, Murad, for one. Don't hesitate to ask him or Erend if you have further questions.
I will. Oh, shit. Fast travel. All right, let's go. Pitchcliff, or whatever the fuck they call it. Why are you walking like that?
Find a use for you.
This is such a fun open world game. I really can't wait for next year for Far Cry 5 and Red Dead Redemption. Those are going to be so fucking perfect games. I don't know which one I'm waiting for. I think probably Red Dead. I'm sort of waiting for them both equally, I'd have to say, but man, that's going to be fun. Hey, look at the beautiful star. Crap. Oh, not that high. Shit.
This must be Pitchcliff. Murad's agent should be at the marketplace by now.
No sign of Murad's guy. He's had plenty of time to investigate.
We'd better look for him.
Damn right.
Hmm.
More tracks. I think someone followed whoever we're following.
That sounds bad.
God damn it.
Has to be Murat's guy. Durval's thugs must have made him.
Maybe because he found something. Look at this. I think he drew a map with his own blood.
Right. Those kind of maps, you know, you better follow.
That might be Pitchcliff. He marked a spot to the north. Could be Durval's location.
And my men are waiting outside of town. I'll grab them and meet you there.
All right. We're getting there. That was weird. All right, we're here.
Like they've been chained up.
Durval's a tinker. He probably experiments on them or strips them for parts.
Maybe I can use them to make some trouble. I'll go in first. Hold off until the fighting starts.
All right. We've got your back.
Oh, you only brought one guy?
Machines! Shoot their chains!
Jesus Christ. What the fuck? Come on now. Try to go a bit too fast. Just a tiny bit too fast.
Shoot their chains!
Come on, what the hell? Why the fuck am I not using these ones? Thank you. Come on. Pick up all this junk around here. Jesus Christ, that went far. So you there? Hello?
Durval says you gotta eat dirt.
spring.
Holy shit. Oh fuck, oh fuck, oh fuck. But of Oh, of course. Oh my God. Thank you.
Hoping it won't scare them off.
What the fuck, man? Come on. I'm stuck.
I just need a minute.
That bit exactly 5 seconds.
This is it.
We have to get through.
They must use these to protect themselves from that awful sound. Durval tried to break me. Shows what he knows.
I should have been with you. Why didn't you come for me? I know I'm a useless trunk, but...
No, idiot. I got a message from Durval saying he wanted to parlay. I didn't come for you because I knew it was a trap. I couldn't let you get hurt. Just didn't think it'd be that good a trap. Thought I could take him out. Now listen, Durval's planning something big in Meridian. He said he'd force Avad to watch as the smoke darkens their precious sun. Your king needs you. No more playing around. You're gonna have to grow up fast.
I will. I promise.
You damn well better, little brother.
Ursa. No, no. Please. I won't let you down. I promise.
God damn.
Erend, I'm so sorry.
We've got to find Durval. But Meridian's a big place.
I'll look through his things. Maybe we can narrow it down.
Got it working. There. Now, say something. Both of you, Duffs.
I don't know. What do you want me to say?
Whatever you want. I just want to hear your voice and keep it for later.
I'll sing, Papa. La 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 la.
There. A song and a laugh, even better than words. And now I can hear them whenever I want.
We're done then? Off to bed with you.
Good night, Mama. Good night, Papa.
Is she gone? What are we going to do? The raids are getting closer and closer to Main Spring. How much longer can we hide like this?
A keepsake from his family. Durval's got nothing left to lose. I think I found something that can help. Let's head back to the palace.
Go. I won't be long, but I need to tend to my sister.
Mm-hmm. Come on.
Most of the colonists take the elevators back down to the village at night. People here won't stand.
I've sent a messenger to the claim to let everyone know.
If there's anything you or your clan need for her arrangements, you need but ask.
There'll be time for all of that later.
Aloy. I'm glad you're back. I'm at a loss about Ersa. To learn she lives, then lose that hope seems cruel.
She wouldn't want us to waste time talking. She'd want us to find Dervahl. She said he raved about smoke darkening the sun. Tell him what you found in his papers.
A letter. It mentioned a shipment of Blaze being sent to a warehouse here. Only, it wasn't addressed to Dervahl. The name was Aeland Forgeman. Does that mean anything to you?
Sounds familiar. Yes, a landlord. The Oseram have been buying up buildings across the city, including one under that name. It's by the edge of the mesa, near the temple. Used to be a shop, but it could serve as a warehouse. If Dervahl used the name as an alias to buy it, he might even be there now.
I'll round up my men.
I'll meet you there.
Erend, wait. Remember that no one hates Dervahl more than your own tribe. The clans would give up much to obtain him.
Take him alive? So you can haggle over him? You can't be serious!
Our security depends on keeping the peace. If the opportunity presents itself, take him alive. Consider that a command. Aloy, a moment, please. When we spoke, Erend didn't wish to dwell on the details of Ersa's death. Understandable, of course. But now that they've been left to my imagination, those details are all I can think about. You were there. Did she suffer?
She's not the one who's suffering now. You are. She died before you could say goodbye.
Is it that obvious? You're right. I'm dwelling on my pain, not just hers. And there's only one thing left that can help. Find Dervahl and bring him before me. He will answer for his crimes.
All right.